Hey guys, welcome back to Lush Aqua. In today's video, we are in conversation with one of the veterans of the fish keeping hobby, Mr. Wispy Mistry. Wispy sir has been in the aquarium hobby for over 40 years now. If you watched the previous video we posted, sir has beautifully explained how he has gone through these 40 years, his whole journey right from 1982 to 2021 keeping fish. Now in today's video, sir, I want to ask you how to groom discus for competitions. Now if a hobbyist goes ahead and gets a discus and wants to enter a discus competition, how or what tips would you want to give that hobbyist so he could raise his discus in such a way that it would be ready for a competition?
Thank you, Mr. Dean. That's a very good question. And to the best of my knowledge, how to groom a discus begins from the time you buy a discus. I will suggest that you buy good quality discus. And when you buy a discus, first of all, you must see the shape of the discus. It should be like a disc. The word discus means a disc, round shape. Then you see the pattern of the fish, how it is, and you see the pattern of the parents also, if you are buying it from some breeder. So it must have good pattern. And once you have bought this fish, they should not be sick fish. They must be healthy and they must have a little bit thickness in them. They should not be very thin or what you call as anorexic fish. And when you bring the fish in your house, the first thing is you must quarantine the fish, because of course you buy fish from a source which does not have any disease or it has been groomed well, so you also groom well, but you have to quarantine your fish. You have to treat it for worms, deworming and other things for 10 days. And what I will advise is your water quality should be very good. If the fish is comfortable in the water quality, it will naturally grow out. So to groom, you must have a good water quality. I'm not telling you to buy very big Bosch multiple technology filters. You see, everyone can afford, but you must have good quality sponge filters, good aeration, and your water quality must be very good. You must use good conditioners, because the water in Bombay and in many places in India has chlorine. So you must use a chlorine remover and a water conditioner, good quality one. You don't sacrifice on that. So once set, the fish is in good environment, you must give it quality food, because these discus fishes and other fishes are always hungry. Also, to groom the fish, you must see that ammonia does not build up and the nitrogen cycle is established in your tank. You let the fish feed for about 10-15 minutes, and later on, if you find that the fish is now not eating, it's enough, you siphon that off. Don't let it remain there. You'll have to work very hard on that. So if there is no ammonia, and if there is hardly any nitrites or nitrates in your tank, the growth of the fish will increase. It will accelerate the growth of the fish. That is one of the main factors. And you will see that those who groom the fish are very much careful about these things. Although your filter is on, you can use external filters also with various biological filter media like rings. And you can also use activated carbon for a certain time, and then you have mechanical filters. Of course, they help in maintaining the water quality, but you must change your water and see that they get good environment. And you must try every 3 months or 4 months. If you find that their feeding has become slow, you deworm them. And the best medicine I suggest for deworming is Metrogyl. You understand? And you can also use terramycin. Nowadays, terramycin is not available in Bombay. So you can go in for Bactrim DS, or you can also go for Ciplox. And there are other things. But try to avoid medication. That is what I say. So where the fish grows, you start selecting the better ones. Some fishes will show you good pattern, good growth, good shape, eye color. Eye color is one of the main factors. In discus competitions, the first factor they see is the size of the fish. The bigger the size of the fish, you are assured of a first place. Then they see the eye color. Eye color means the inner part is pupil and the outer part, that is the ring, what you call it, is the iris. You see the color of the iris. So if you see fishes with nice red iris and shape and the size of the fins, you know, the dorsal fin size should be almost the same as the ventral fin size. You understand? And the fish should not be long. It should be round like this. You understand? And it must be lively. One of the main factors which were being judged in international competitions was liveliness. There were marks for liveliness. Because you'll see some fish, although they are having a lot of pattern, good color, they are not lively. They see you and they run away. But there are some fishes we are so lively that apart from having good pattern and good shape and good eyes and good proportional fins, proportional parts, they will come to you when you call them. You don't want to have a cat or a dog in your house that runs away. You want it to come to you the same way you want that to happen to your fish. So this is one of the main factors you select. You understand? So these are a few of the points which I can tell you right now, and right. Then we'll see later.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I wish you all the best.
Thank you so much, sir.